Right. Shall we start? All of you, as soon as you enter, your register number should be entered in the message box. Right. So last class we had discussed about this. So code smart, not hard, do less. So here is what happening is, EJB is nothing but the enterprise Java bins, so that is nothing but the we should have the smartness. Even laboratory programs also same thing. So system will be generating maximum code, and we have to write the bit code. That's all. Interfaces, packages, everything they will be. It will be generating. Even laboratory programs, I'll tell you next class. So hardly will be writing, not even 10 lines. So remaining code, it will be generated automatically. Only thing is we should remember the steps. That's all. That is what the here code smart and not hard. So server side and how it will be working. So apart from that, the simple way examples we can do, we can discuss. So many people are doing individual modules. So they want to combine it. They want to merge this. So they can use the enterprises also. They can merge the list. All these things can be done here also. So that is what we have discussed. So here is business when they are doing sending the SMSs, so sending the mails, automatics, all these things can be done in this advanced EJB. So that is what we'll be discussing. And up to here we have done it, and how to write it, the SMTP mail servers and store the users, all these things automatically will be generated. And now today we'll be discussing this. So each simplified examples, so here is nothing but the, see here, database dot store user and user. So mail service dot emails user to server. So that means what? Once user information, it is stored there, whatever the particulars they have taken, mail IDs, all these things. So automatically it will be sending. So some of the examples we can see it. Whenever we are sending, we are registering some of the workshops, conference, immediate we'll be getting the messages. As soon as you submit. So that means what they have done it, all these things. So once it is done, so automatically it will be sending immediate response to us. So that is what the this one. If we could make the computational element transparent, we would have the position to pay greater attention to the business logic. So that is what the business logic is, nothing but that only. So that means what? So time constraints, every minute they'll be having the crucial. So when they are doing business, all these things should be done properly. So otherwise, what will happen nowadays? You are seeing the business competition. What will be happening? So they should be good enough. Not only education, business. Even you can say education also. So whatever the industry is required, once we enter into the organizations or companies also. So based on their projects, we should be able to switch over one platform to another platform or one area to another area, whatever it may be. So all these things we should be able to change ourselves. So that is one of the examples. Now we'll be having the container. So container is nothing but the host provides the services to guest the applications. So host will be providing the services to guest the application. So whatever the guest applications is required, so the host people, whatever they are doing, they have to do it. So for example, Amazon now online services we are seeing. Previously we should go to shops, we find out that we have to see the all these things, then we have to take it. So nowadays what we are doing, if I want to buy one shirt and pant, so I can go to some of the websites and we can register it, we can pay online and they'll be sending directly to our home. So that is what the implications. And because nowadays what's happening is nobody is having the time to spend. So that is the reason everybody is busy. So they're sitting at home, they're doing the doing all online businesses. So for that, whatever it is required, they'll be doing here itself. So here is nothing but we have the users actions and they have the email services and image processing. So images also will be there and images also processing will be there based on this one. Nowadays we are seeing, that's what the best examples for the online only business. Suppose if you want to buy mobiles, images will be displaying. So suppose if you want to buy dresses, the dresses and which type of dresses, which type of what is the range of the cost, all these things will be displayed. So that is where the modules operating inside the runtime of the container. This is also one container. So container is nothing but what host will be providing the services to the guest, whatever the applications they need. So now I want to buy one day mobile, one day mask, now I want to purchase it. So we can go to the sites and we can search it and we can see the rates and what is our budget, all these things we can see. That is also called the container. So they are providing the applications which one we need. That is what the happening. So next one, you have the clients, different clients you are having, services A, services B. Is there container A, container B? Using the runtime container to abstract the physical locations of the code. So abstract the physical locations of the code. So servers will be one side and clients may be n number of the clients they will be requesting. So that is the reason we have to do all the interfaces, abstracts, all these things can be done in the programming code. So they have the different containers. You see here, they will be dividing. One container, one objects we can say. So they'll be, their details will be different. A container services, whatever requested by the client A, their object is different. Their details may be different. So I will be ordering only one item, for example, client A. Client B may be requesting n number of the items. So based on that, they will be sending the packages and collecting the information, collecting the items, and they'll be putting it into the one bag or different bags or different covers or whatever it may be, then they'll be sending. So that is what the second one is called, the using runtime connect to abstract the physical locations of the code. So physical locations of the code is nothing but after giving the orders, they will be getting the report. Based on that, they'll be going ahead. So their container will be different, my container will be different, X container will be different, my Y container will be the different. Next is EJB, the specifications. So EJB specifications is nothing but already we had discussed, that is called the server side components model for the distributed operating system. So whatever you are doing the enterprises, this is nothing but the server side component model for the distributed business applications. Distributed business applications. Say here, if you want a dress, that it will go to take to the some other websites. So they will be providing their rates, all these things, or separate link, we can say separate links or separate websites, whatever it may be. So based on their business, they'll be done. So that is called the server side component. So being a customer, what we are doing is just whatever we need, we are entering the information. That is what the EJB is, the specifications. Let us see what's happening in this. EJB specifications dictates the capabilities of the required of a compliant EJB container. So Enterprise Java Beans architecture is an architecture for the development and deployment of the component-based business applications. So they have to develop and deploy the components of the business applications. So whatever they are using the applications written using the Enterprise's Java Beans architectures are scalable. So that is nothing but the whatever they are writing the code in EJB, that is nothing but the scalable, transactional, and multi-user secured. So all these things applications EJB is providing for us. EJB is providing for us, that is nothing but the scalable. So the, what is the quantity, all these things we can do, we can be able to find out. So they can be able to scalable and transactional, so they can do the business for the transactionals and multi-user secured. Multi-users also can be accessed for that simultaneously and secured. Security is most important, otherwise nobody will access for that. For example, if I enter my credit card information, if somebody able to access that credit card or my users information, then nobody will go for the online business. So everywhere security, user security, they should maintain it. That is what EJB also providing for that. So now these applications may be written once and then deployed on the only server platform that supports the Enterprise Java Beans specifications. So this is applications is written only once, that is deployed from the servers, and it will be running from the servers and Java Beans specifications, whatever it is required, that it will be supporting the Java Beans specifications. So we can say the definitions, that's what I told you first. Enterprise's Java Beans is a standard server-side component. EJB is nothing but the server-side component model for distributed business applications. So this is the component there. So distributed business applications, everything it is available, everything is possible here. So one person way of processing, maybe data may be different, processing informations may be different, all these things here it is available for the distributed applications. So distributed applications is nothing but different type of applications. So different type of the business also we can say, for example, medical equipments, I told you mask, all these things are maybe some other things. So are if you come for the dresses, different. If you come for mobiles, electronic goods, home applications, everything it is available. Many people nowadays, they are purchasing TVs, all these things in through online business only. They'll be giving sometimes offers, all those things they'll be utilizing. That is what the EJB stand, EJB is nothing but the server-side component model for the distributed applications. That is what the EJB definitions and this one. So EJB defines models for the piecing together a full system by integrating modules. So integrating modules is nothing but, that's what I told you initially, this is nothing but the different modules will be there, finally they'll be integrating. So links will be there. So for example, you have developed one web pages for your equipments, and somebody will be designed for some other equipments, or I may be designing for my business applications. All these things will be giving link. So that's what we have learned, file forward, linking, plugins, all these things will be giving the linking between EJB. So that is what the all, any type of the files, any type of the HTMLs, all these things will be supporting here. So then they will be processing the information. That is what the integrating the models. Integrate the models is nothing but the different type of the models they can be combining. Each component may be represent a collection of business process. So components means nothing but already I told you. So whatever the customers are required, so it will be making the host. So the host will be making ready for the customer requirement. That is what the components and collection of the business process, and this will run centralized on the server. All these things will be running in the centralized server. So you are requesting the server will be finding the whatever you need. So that is what the will be happening. the distributed natures will provide the mechanism to spread modules across the different processes. So here is nothing but that's what I told you already. So distributed is nothing but the dividing the modules. Already distributed the modules. So whatever you are requesting based on that, it will be going there. So nature will provide the mechanism to spread the modules across different processes, physical mechanics, or even entire the networks. That is what the EJB specifications. EJB is also an aggregate technology. It weighs up other facts of the Java Enterprises Edition, such as messaging, transactions, resource management, persistence, and web services. These are all the editions we'll be focusing. Messaging, transactions, resource management, persistence, and web services. So this is where the will be happening, the informations in EJB. So component types. Component types is nothing but you have the some of the points are there. So one is called the modeling real life objects and concepts is one of the first skills a programming must develop. That is what the first one, because of the POJO, that is nothing but the plain old Java object. Plain old Java object class is just like any other class. It does not become the EJB until, so this is nothing but the assembled, packed, deployed. So that is nothing but deployed is nothing but I will show you when I'm telling the program. So once you complete this program, you have to deploy that. That means what? It will be connecting all these things one to one, all the programs, all the modules, then we'll be able to run the programs. So here is everything. Just we have to click one command, deployed. So automatically integrated all these things. Then it will be running the programs. So next lab programs I'll tell you. So your 11th program have made it ready. So that is nothing but the just we are writing maybe four programs are there, looks like bigger program, but nothing is there. Every code will be created by system itself. Hardly will be writing 10 lines of the code, that's all. So basics, whatever you know, HTML two text will be taking. So that code will be writing the two text fields, and that will be passing the information to server and getting the information posting to the client. That's what we'll be doing. That I'll tell you when I'm telling the laboratory programs. So here is simple. Only thing is we have to use our brain. That's it. So many files will be created. So that is not anyway, system will be creating. So interfaces, packages, whatever we are doing, automatically it will be creating. So our side, one is called one HTML, one is called the server side programming. We have to write it. So that server side program, that is also simple one. So you are how to drag the information from the here. So here is just how to utilize the technology we have to learn it yourself. So next is accessed via the container. This is an important distinction. EJB becomes such only in the context of the EJB container. So EJB container in turn is responsible for equipping POJO with EJB services. Next is server-side component types is nothing but you have the two things. Let us see this one. Server-side components types of the reside exclusively on the server, and the client must be interact with them via some indirections. So via in some directions we have to access the servers and we have to get the information. There are the two major server-side components. One is called the session beans, one is called the message driven beans. So session beans is nothing but which explore the view for the client invoke upon. So what is the first one is nothing but the view for the client to invoke upon. The message driven is nothing but which act as event listener, which act as the event listener. These are all the two things, server side components. One is called the session bean, another one is called the message driven bean. Session bean and message driven bean. So session bean, you can see here, if a EJB is a grammar, session bean are the verbs. So you can see here the diagram. See, you have the container and the client will be there and proxy will be there. So in one network, one proxy server will be there. So in our system also, we have taken the internet connections. One proxy systems will be, server will be making, through that will be accessing all the people servers, all the people internet access services. So here is client invoking upon the proxy object responsible for delegating the call along to the EJB container. So along with the, these also creating the object, these also responsible for the EJB container to send and receive the informations whatever requested by the client. So session bins is frequently container business methods. The client does not access the EJB directly. Already we had discussed, client does not access the EJB directly. So some other way to have to access it, which allows the container to perform all the shots of the magics before requesting the finally hit the target methods. So here is nothing but some of the containers will be there, whatever you are creating, we are requesting, creating the objects, containers, searching, then it will be moved to the servers. Then it will be coming back to this one, informations. Next is three types of the session bins are available. Session bins itself, three, you have the session bills. So here is nothing but you are requesting something. So here is nothing but the instance panel will be there. So randomly we'll be selecting any one of these. That is what this one. And these are all the useful for functions in which state does not need the need to be carried from the innovation to the innovation. So that is what the stateless session bins. And here one more is nothing but here is random, once it is selected the random code IC is equal to 5. So that information, once it is created the object, so whatever you are doing the operations for that object. So I'll be, that's what I told you the examples for that object. I'll be entering the five purchasing mobile. I will be purchasing, somebody will be purchasing some other things. So all one person, one object informations will be displayed there only. So you have the given ID, because whenever we are purchasing, we are with respect to our mail IDs, our user ID, password, based on that we might have registered that. So based on that, that informations will be stored into the particular users database. One transactions, every transactions will be stored there. That is the reason we are able to do whatever we have given transactions, whatever we have given orders, all the informations we can be able to see it based on the identifications. So that's what only our informations we can be able to see it from your website. So state full session bins is nothing but in this, every request upon the given proxy references is guaranteed to ultimately invoke upon the same bin instance. So that is important. Proxy reference guarantee. Whatever we are doing the informations, whatever we are doing the processing data, all these things should be guaranteed, should be done it. So it, if goes something wrong, so it's a financial transactions, it is very difficult to transact. That is the reason they should take care of all those things. Next is singleton bins is nothing but the requesting. So finally, EJB container will be there. Sometimes we don't need any more than one backing instance for your business. So sometimes small business not required more than some of the identifications. So in this case, it may be mocked to eagerly loan when the and the applications is deployed. Therefore, it may be leveraged to fire the applications life events. This is what the three things in session bins. So one is called the stateless session bins. Another one is called the stateful session bins, singleton bins. These are all the three important things in session bins. Now we'll go back to the next one. Second one is managed driven bins. So here is, you see here, previously we have seen whatever we have requested, it will be going for the container on this one. So now you are requesting messages. So broker will be there. That is what the third person will be there to accessing the servers. So new thread executions will be there. That broker, once it is created the object, based on that it will be this one. Because why it is created, the object is nothing but C++. All these things we have studied. So three students informations, once it is taken, three objects you have created. N numbers means N objects you have created. So that student information only we have to, we should be able to get it back. Otherwise, what will happen? It will show the wrong results. So that is what here also same thing. Asynchronous messaging is a paradigms in which two or more applications communicate via message describing the business event. So EJB 3.1 interacts with the messaging systems via Java container architecture. 1.6 is nothing but the which acts, that is nothing but the diagram, previous diagrams. So that is nothing but the which acts the abstraction of the layer that enables any systems to be adapted as a valid users, valid senders. The MDB interns in the listener that consumes messages and may either handle them directly or delegates further processing to other EJB components. That is what the happening. And message driven beans also stateless here. In this, another one is called the one common provider of asynchronous messaging in the Java message services. So one common point will be there to send the messages in the Java message services. That is called the JMS, Java message services. If message is sent to the JMS, topic or queue will be there. So many people requesting, so it will be stored into the queue. EMDB may be created to take the actions upon the that event. So sometimes when we are discussing about the stacks, queues, why it is required, stack is nothing but 1-1-1 operations. That is nothing but the recursive operations. When we are doing the merge sort, queue sort, all these things will be done recursively. So for one values, if you do it, remaining will be taken care of that function itself. So on that one. So queue, when we are discussing first in, first out, why these people are telling these simple programs, all these things. So you can see here. So this is what the real-time applications also will be doing. So with there will be we might have discussed to pay the electricity bill, to pay the to take the cinema tickets, or some things are to once you go to the doctor or maybe based on the appointment, there also queue something will be there. So all these things we might have discussed it. So this is also the real-time applications. So message queue is nothing but what? When we are doing the business, many people will be requesting their servers. So in that case, what will happen? So all their objects will be stored into the database. So then it will be distributing, will be accessing all the informations. That is what will be happening in this. Next is entity beans. So entity beans is nothing but what will happen? Request will be there, users will be there. And here is nothing but the POGV. Here is nothing but the EJB containers, next the database. So finally it will move to the database. While session beans are our verbs, entity beans are the nouns here. So there are aims to express an object view of the resources stored within the RDBMS, a process commonly known as the object relational mapping in this case. So here is nothing but what our aim is, nothing but requesting something. So you have the images, all these things in images. Once you like this, then you are giving the address. So once you're given the address, that information, so all these things, what you have given, they might have given for the images, code numbers, all these things, then it will be displayed, it will be stored in your their database. Then 1-1-1-1 they're taking and they'll be doing the processing. The entity types is modeled as a POGV and became a managed object only when associated with construct called the javax.persistence.entityManager. All that, all type of the information. Next is Java persistence model. The sister to the EJB 3.1 specifications is the Java persistence API. So that is nothing but the 2.0 developed in JSR 317. So this website, you can see it here. So ejbjsp.org. So EJB maybe became equipped with the facilities defined by the JPA, such that modifying the properties of the managed object will be reflected automatically in the backing the database. So all these things in detail, if you want still how it will be working, what is the life cycle, all these things you can refer that website, you can see that. In addition to support within the EJB, JPA may be used to standalone Java standard editions that is nothing but a standard edition, is nothing but the SE environments. Next is the persistence is a simple higher level abstraction above the Java database connectivity. So persistence is nothing but the collection of the all the informations, database informations, if you take. So you have, we are creating how to create the database, how to access that. It is all collect full information, inserting, deleting, display, all the informations, collectively informations is called the, once we do complete that, we'll call it as the persistence. One more laboratory program is there here, and we using the database that we'll see it in the laboratory. By exploring the database and objects to the developer, backend rows may be queried, loaded, updated, or removed without explicitly having to go through contacted APIs or language such as SQL commands, all these things. So we can do the all the operations in the persistence. So the container services, we are having applications developed should return the rules of their business and leave the mechanism for reliable distributed systems to middleware providers. So when they are developing the this one, they have to write the rules, regulations, all these things, business rules, regulations, once it is completed. That's what the, when you are talking about the big data, all these things, business model they'll be doing. So they'll be collecting the informations, then processing and filtering all one by one to complete the process to reach to the customer. So starting from the customer, again reaching to the customer. Once process, complete that one. That was the business model, they have to do it. So here also the same thing, rules, regulations, they should write it. That means what? If something goes wrong, who is the responsible for that? So all these things, they'll be having some of the rules. Otherwise, what will happen? The customer, when the deliver by also, they can do something because they have the authentication, all these things. Otherwise, they'll be taking care. So some of the business rules. Or you might have done some of the business transactions, maybe amount got cut here, it is not credited there. So all these things, rules, regulations, they should write it. If everything goes somewhere wrong, so then what should be done for that? So everywhere they should have written it. Business level, the mechanism of the reliable distributed systems are the middleware providers. So in case of the EJB, the component model defines our interchangeable parts and the container services are the specialists that perform the work upon the them. The specification providers, dependency injection. So you have the dependency injection specifications and concurrency, instance pooling and caching or caching, transactions, security, timers, naming and objects, stores, interoperability, lifecycle callbacks, so interceptors, Java enterprises platforms integrations. All these things combinedly, they have to do the business cycles. Then only they can be able to succeed that one. So these were the dependency injection, concurrency, instance pooling or caching, transactions, security, timers, naming and object stores. So these are all the things, security, transactions, so timings, so namings and objects, interoperability, lifecycle callbacks, interceptors, Java enterprise platform integrations, all these things should be done. Then only they can complete their processes. Next is dependency injection. A component-based approach to software design is brings with its complications of the intermodule communication, tightly coupled discrete units together violates module interdependence and separations of the concerns. So here is order, once it is accepts, process the order payment verification. Next is the stock management, shipping, delivery. So plumbing is nothing but the, they have to do the complete the process is nothing but what? Once you have the order accept, that means what? Before accepting only whether the stock is available or not. So sometimes we are able to see that one. Informations will be there once you click it out of stock. or only two items, available items, two, three. So that is what they have to take it. While using the common lookup code leads to the maintenance of the more plumbing. So maintenance also important. So they have to write the code such a way that once it is over availability objects, then they should not be able to allow us to do the any processing for taking that elements. Suppose only two are there, if you are trying to place the order for 10, that is also should not be allowed. So the code should be written all these things. So they have to write it, the code perfectly for this. So once you have given the order acceptancy, so process the order payment, process order and payment verifications, they should be done it. Next is stock management. So that means what 10 is available. If I give 10, then stock management when somebody tries also should not be allowed to do the operations. That means already stock over. So all these things, stock maintenance, they should do it properly. As EJP is a component centric architecture, so this is nothing but it provides the means to reference the development modules in decoupled fashions. The end result is that you will have adhered to the contact and let the container provides the implementation at deployment time. So this providing the reference dependent modules, decoupled fashions. So modules is nothing but already we had discussed decoupled, decentralized. Every modules they have that one. That's what I told you. One main page will be there. Based from there, all the links they might have given it, because everything cannot be accommodated in the same page. You know that HTML when we are defining. So once you search it, based on that, it will be moving from one page to another page. Maybe file forward or whatever, exchanging all these things and permissions. So here is the pseudocode for this. Looks like prototype, user modules, instance members, dependent module, a mail module. Here is nothing but the mail module. You see here your function mail user, mail dot send mail. So me at ejb dot some domain. So which domain you are having? So that domains. So here is dependence modules and mail server module. So this is the code for the. Looks like it will be there like this. That's what we'll be writing the laboratory programs. You'll be seeing all type of the codes. So maximum only three lab programs are there. One is called the database, one is called the just to do some of the operations. So one is called the displaying some of the commands, lines. So some of the examples we are seeing, once you see that three laboratory programs, you'll be getting the ideas. Then you can implement other things also. So here is, are the dependent module annotations services two purposes here. One is called the defines a dependency upon some service of the type main module. So defines the dependencies upon the some services. So what are the services is required to do that one? So what are the services? For example, that's what I told you, the best example is nothing but 10 items are available. I have booked that. So next immediate one more person is requested. So before requesting only that services to be done. Services is nothing but that information that should be updated automatically. So that services should run, then this person's action this one. The same items when you are purchasing, then that services should run it. So update that particular table or update the some of the informations, that it will be done. So automatically should do it. So then only it is possible to maintain the business. So user module may not be deployed until this dependency is satisfied. Next is mark the instance member mail as a candidate for the injection. The container will populate the field during the deployment. Dependency injection encourages coding to interfaces and not to any particular implementations. This is what the will be happening. So all these things, codes majority will be created there itself. Only thing is, which is the main points it is required for you, that you have to learn for the this one. So majority is here is theory only. You have to learn theory. So code is already we have learned it. Whatever we are learning, that are only same information, same code will be doing. So before, after what it is coming, whatever the main points, key points are there, that you have to learn it. Next is called the concurrency. So concurrency is nothing but assuming each service is a represented by one instance. Represented by the one instance. Each service is represented in the one instance. Dependency injection alone is a fine solution for the single threaded applications. So that it will be considered as called the single threaded applications, and only one client may be accessing a resource at a given time. So all the resources, all these things. So one person is doing some of the process, that one how to do the process. So you see the business techniques, all these things. So when we learn about the threads, so sometimes Java programming, we learn the threads. So one thread is printing from 1 to 100, another one is called 300 to 400, and another one is called 1000 to 2000. When it is happening, the threads, how it will be moving from one to another. So how it will be accessing. That means what? If one is executing, another will be waiting state. Otherwise, it will be difficult. So that is the reason sometimes when we are doing the process, it will be taking some time, because some of the services to be run. Because when I have purchased 10 items already, so when I'm making the bill processing, all these things, immediately some other person sees nothing but, so it will wait it till my complete the process, then it will run the services, then it will be updating the information, then in items are not available, something like that. So that is what the threaded applications. Only one client may be accessing the resources at the given time. So one person, one resources will be there. It will be accessing the servers and getting the informations. However, this quickly becomes a problem in situations where a centralized server is fit to serve many simultaneous requests. So this we are seeing all these things, because you are familiar now, because 10 years back, 15 years back, if teacher says this one may be difficult to understand, because that time it was not there, online business, what is this online business, all these things. Even when we have seen some of the projects initially when they told online business implementing all these things, so whether it will work out or not, India sometimes we had the doubt. So nowadays it came to an existence. That is what happening. So everything will take time to this one. Internet, you see, so maybe 10, 15 years back, taking mobile only, it was very difficult task. Maybe 10, 20 years back, something if you think. Taking mobile connections only, bit difficult. It was not getting the same, all these things. So nowadays, you see, immediate. If I want to buy new mobile, I should have money, that's it. Can go there and we can buy. That's what it huge development. So before that, what's happening is internet also. Internet also, it was very difficult. Nowadays, everybody is there able to buy the internet. So whether you like it or not, also we are able to purchase it nowadays. So nowadays, that is also one mandatory. So because many transactions we are doing. So sometimes we want to book the ticket, sometimes we want to pay the fees. All other operations also, we are doing everything in this case also. So that is what maximum business transactions. That's what I mean to say is nothing but what. So many of these transactions, you are directly or indirectly are involved. You know the business transactions, how it will be happening, all these things. Sometimes when you are selecting, the items will be there. When you are making out of stock, it will be coming. So how much business, how much speed they are doing. So systems also. So when we were studying all two, they are telling 2 GB hard disk, but to 4 GB, oh, you 4 GB. So nowadays, it may pen drive we are taking 8 GB, 16 GB, 32 GB or 64, 120. So maybe that is not the storages. So it's also got increased. So you see, hard disk and all 2 GB means it was there this much size that time. Nowadays, pen drive to 8 GB also only this much. Small piece, you can be able to see it. So that's where the business development, all these things is happening. So now you have the, however, this quickly becomes the problems in situations where a centralized server is to fit serve many simultaneous request. So server will be doing simultaneously requesting all these servers. Deadlock like live looks and raise the conditions or some of the possible nightmares arising out of an environment in the which threaded may complete for shared resources. So database already you have learned deadlock is nothing but what. So you know that live locks also raise conditions. All these things you have learned the operating system. So you see here that it is applicable in this case business techniques. EJB allows the application deployment to side set up the problems entirely thanks to the series of concurrence policies. So this is what the EJB allows the applications developer to sidestep problems. So this is what the thanks to the concurrency policies. This is what the concurrency policies. Next is called the instance pooling and caching. So this will see it into the next class. So I'll stop this one. Probably it will take another 2 to 3 hours to complete this, and we'll see the laboratory programs next class. So EJB, that's what I feel, very easy programs. Only thing is we have to learn the process. Before starting, I'll be sending one file. So keep with you. You have to practice lab programs parallelly. Let it take some time, because otherwise what's happening is you are not practicing. This is called the steps you have to follow, because steps are a bit more. So once you follow the steps, then it is easy to implement the programs. Code writing is simple. So because you have to, I'll send you the file. So based on that, I'll be telling one step. So go ahead, complete it parallelly with laboratory programs. Probably it will take, actually, once you are familiar, they have just 10 minutes to complete the laboratory programs. Actually, EJB, you can complete it compared to the previous programs also. So that's what you have to practice. Only thing is most important. That we'll see it either tomorrow or day after tomorrow. I'll speak to Bhushan sir, whatever he says, based on that, either tomorrow or day after tomorrow, we'll see it. Right, sir. So I'll be stopping the class today. I'll take the attendance. See, all the people not entered in the message box, attendance. So next class onwards, you have to, whenever you are connecting, you have to enter your register number in the message box. That is what your timings, it will mention there. So simply connecting end moment, it will not work out. So not now. So next class onwards, you have to enter the attendance. Based on that only, I'll be taking the attendance. Answer attendance one.
It's present, sir.
Continue the attendance. 2, 3.
Present, sir.
4 present, sir.
5 next. Present, sir.
6 present, sir.
7.
8 present, sir. 8 present, sir.
9 present, sir.
7 present, sir.
Next 10.
Sir, 7 present, sir.
Okay.
11 present, sir.
10 Okay, 10 absent.
14 present, sir.
Next.
6 present, sir.
17 present, sir.
6,
sir. 18 present, sir.
16, sir.
Okay.
17 present,
19
sir.
Present, sir.
18?
Sorry, 18 present, sir.
19 present, sir.
20 present, sir.
21 present, sir.
22 present, sir.
23 present, sir.
24?
25 present, sir.
26 present, sir.
27, sir.
28?
30 29? Present, sir.
29?
30 present, sir. Sir, 30 present, sir.
Okay. KD series?
2 present, sir.
3 present, sir.
4 present, sir.
5 present, sir. 6 present, sir.
7 present, sir.
8 present, sir.
9. 10. 11.
11 present, sir.
12 present, sir.
13.
14, sir. 14 present, sir.
16.
16 present, sir.
17. 18.
18 present, sir.
19.
19 present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
Okay. Absent is BY series 2, 11, 24, 28, 29 and TD series.
Present, sir, 10 is absent.
Absent is only I am telling.
Absent is 10. I am 11 present, sir. BY 11.
Madam, absent is BY 2, 10, 24, 28, 29 and TD series 9, 10, 13 and 17. Okay. Right.